Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to continue with our lesson number 8 of social science and role of parliament in a democratic country. This is the name of the chapter. This is the second video. In the last video, we studied how India has adopted the government, which kind of government. Then there is parliament, who is the supreme head of the nation for administration, and president is the head of the parliament, which has got two houses, Lok Sabha lower house, Rajya Sabha upper house. And we also saw that the representative elected by us, they enjoy the complete or supreme power to administer the nation. And we also understood that how these people get the right to administer, because we have elected them in through casting our votes. Let's proceed further. Now the functions of the parliament are to control the government and to provide information and guidance to it. Okay, so the Lok Sabha, the parliament has got these functions, which is to control the government and to provide information and guidance to it. Second is to make laws and make amendments in it. Amendments means the changes. They can make new laws as well as they can make changes in the existing laws. Understood? Now, how is the Lok Sabha formed? Lok Sabha, or the House of the People. Okay. The election for the Lok Sabha and the State Legislative Assembly, that is Vidhan Sabha, are conducted in the same way. Lok Sabha elections are held every 5 years. Each constituency is represented by one elected member in the parliament. The candidates who contest for the seat in parliament are usually active in various political parties. The elected candidate is known as the member of the parliament or MP. All these elected members collectively form the Lok Sabha. So you understand? A different whole of the country. It is such a big country, such a huge country with so much population. So whole of the country is divided into different small territories, which are called constituencies. Now each constituency is represented by one elected member in the parliament depending on the population. The place, suppose Kutch, it is divided into different constituencies, different territories, and each territory is represented by one elected member in the parliament. The candidates who contest for the seat in the parliament are usually active in various political parties. These candidates jo khade hote hain elections mein, they are usually active in various bahut sari political parties mein wo log active hote hain, kaam karte hain. The elected candidate is known as the मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. जिनको हमने वोट देकर इलेक्ट किया उनको हम बोलते हैं मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट और एमपी. ऑल दीज एमपी टुगेदर कलेक्टिवली दे फॉर्म द लोकसभा. अंडरस्टूड हाउ लोकसभा इज फॉर्म्ड. नाउ हाउ इज द रूलिंग पार्टी फॉर्म्ड. आफ्टर द इलेक्शंस ऑफ द लोकसभा पार्टी वाइज लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट इज फॉर्म्ड. सो इलेक्शंस हो गया लोकसभा का, फिर पार्टी वाइज द लिस्ट ऑफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट इज फॉर्म्ड. फ्रॉम दिस लिस्ट इट बिकम्स क्लियर हाउ मेनी मेंबर्स फ्रॉम विच पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज आर देयर. सपोज कच्छ में हमने भाजपा को, मैक्सिमम लोगों ने भाजपा को वोट दिया. ओके, लेकिन हो सकता है गुजरात के दूसरे प्रोविंसेस में, दूसरे डिस्ट्रिक्ट में डिफरेंट अदर पार्टी को चूज किया, वो लोग ने इलेक्ट किया. ओके, इट मे बी कांग्रेस, इट मे बी एनी अदर पार्टी. ओके, so all these parties together, BJP हो, कांग्रेस हो, दूसरी कोई हो, उन सबकी लिस्ट बनाते हैं कि किस पर्सन को कितने वोट मिले और वो पर्सन किस रूलिंग पार्टी का है, कौन सी पार्टी का है. ओके, सो फ्रॉम दिस लिस्ट इट बिकम्स क्लियर हाउ मेनी मेंबर्स फ्रॉम विच पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज आर देयर. इफ एनी पार्टी वॉन्ट्स टू फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट देन देर शुड बी मेजोरिटी ऑफ इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स फ्रॉम दैट पार्टी. सपोज 28 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स हैं गुजरात में, आउट ऑफ 28 20 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ने बीजेपी को चूज किया, और बाकी चार डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ने कांग्रेस को चूज किया, बाकी दो तीन डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ने डिफरेंट अदर प्लेसेस को सॉरी बाकी डिफरेंट डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स को दूसरे रूलर्स को चूज किया, दूसरे पर्सन को चूज किया. ओके तो क्या होगा, मेजोरिटी किसकी बनी, मेजोरिटी ऑफ लोगों ने किसको चूज किया, बीजेपी को. सो बीजेपी विल बी द रूलिंग पार्टी फॉर गुजरात. यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाई, बिकॉज मैक्सिमम पीपल ऑफ गुजरात हैव वोटेड द बीजेपी पार्टी, तो बीजेपी पार्टी विल बी द रूलिंग पार्टी फॉर गुजरात. दूसरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ने भले ही कांग्रेस के पर्सन को इलेक्ट किया या दूसरे कोई पर्सन को इलेक्ट किया, तो वो पर्टिकुलर डिस्ट्रिक्ट में वो पर्सन ही रूल करेगा. ऐसा नहीं है कि उनको जबरदस्ती हम लोग बीजेपी का रूलर दे देंगे, नो. वहीं का जो पर्सन इलेक्टेड होगा वही रूल करेगा, बट फॉर द हेड ऑफ गुजरात बीजेपी ही रूल करेगा. अंडरस्टूड, वो पर्टिकुलर डिस्ट्रिक्ट को शायद कांग्रेस का लीडर रूल कर सकता है, लेकिन पूरे गुजरात को बीजेपी का रूलर ही, यानी बीजेपी का इलेक्टेड पर्सन ही रूल करेगा. अंडरस्टूड दिस मच. सो इफ एनी पार्टी वॉन्ट्स टू फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट, देन देर शुड बी अ मेजोरिटी ऑफ इलेक्टेड मेंबर्स फ्रॉम दैट पार्टी. After the elections, the leader of the party of a coalition of the parties which has a clear majority in the parliament is appointed as a prime minister in the Lok Sabha. Abhi jaisa humne dekha Gujarat mein, okay, ki different districts mein se majority of the districts they voted for BJP. Same rule, same thing applies to whole of the country. Agar puri country mein jitne bhi states hain, usme se maximum states ne koi particular party ko पार्टी के मेंबर को इलेक्ट किया, ओके, तो क्या होगा, दैट पार्टी विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज द रूलिंग पार्टी और द यू नो पार्टी विथ अ क्लियर मेजॉरिटी. ओके, एंड उनका जो लीडर होगा, वो पार्टी का जो लीडर होगा, ही विल बी अपॉइंटेड एज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर इन द लोकसभा. द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया इज द हेड ऑफ द रूलिंग पार्टी. रूलिंग पार्टी क्यों बोलते हैं उसको, क्यों रूल करती है वो, क्योंकि हमने उनको इलेक्ट किया है, पूरे इंडिया के लोगों ने मिलके उनको इलेक्ट किया है. अंडरस्टूड, सो द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया इज द हेड ऑफ द रूलिंग पार्टी. द प्राइम मिनिस्टर सिलेक्ट्स मिनिस्टर्स फ्रॉम द मेंबर्स ऑफ हिज पार्टी. इन दिस वे द काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स इज फॉर्म्ड. एज आई गिव यू द एग्जांपल दैट हाउ अ टीचर इज इलेक्टेड, शी इज सपोज शी इज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड देन शी इलेक्ट्स डिफरेंट यू नो मॉनिटर्स फ्रॉम योर क्लास. इन द सेम वे प्राइम मिनिस्टर विल सिलेक्ट जो भी उनको पसंद हो या जो भी उनको लगे कि सो एंड सो पर्सन इज केपेबल इज लायबल फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर डेजिग्नेशन दैट. इन दिस वे द काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स इज फॉर्म्ड. अंडरस्टूड, आई गिव यू द एग्जांपल ऑफ काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स, होम मिनिस्टर, एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर, देन शिपिंग इंडस्ट्री, व्हाट यू कॉल, रेलवे मिनिस्टर. ऑल दीज मिनिस्टर्स टुगेदर आर कॉल्ड काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स. इन शॉर्ट, काउंसिल मीन्स वी कैन कंसिडर group of ministers. The ministers with prime minister take all the decisions. So along with the prime minister, with the consent of the prime minister, these ministers, council of ministers, they take or decide the things for whole of our country. These ministers take care of the responsibilities of the work related to their respective ministries, such as health, education, finance, etc. So depending on the responsibility which is given to them, whether it is a health department, whether it is education minister, whether finance minister, whatever decisions they wish to take, you know, whatever rule they wish to form for their particular department, with the help or with the consent of the prime minister, they can either make new laws or they can also make changes in the existing laws. As recently we have seen how the education is, you know, new policy is going to be introduced throughout the country. How is that done? That means the education minister, along with the permission of the prime minister, has decided that there is going to be a change in the education system for whole of the country. Each minister is responsible for any question related to his ministry to the members of parliament. That means what? Whatever decision he takes, suppose education minister has taken a decision of new policy amendment in our education system, And if any other member of the parliament has any query, has any question related to that, related to education, then the education minister has to answer, has to give a convincing answer to the member of parliament. Remember, members of parliament does not include only ruling party. BJP ke hi members of parliament hai, not necessary. कांग्रेस के भी मेंबर्स हैं पार्लियामेंट में, क्योंकि कांग्रेस भी इलेक्ट हुई है फ्रॉम डिफरेंट अदर स्टेट्स. एज आई टोल्ड यू, आउट ऑफ 28 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ गुजरात 20 सीट्स अगर बीजेपी को मिली हैं, 4 सीट्स कांग्रेस को भी तो मिली ना, तो कांग्रेस का पर्सन भी तो बनेगा ना मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. तो दैट इज कॉल्ड द ऑपोजिशन पार्टी. नाउ दैट ऑपोजिशन पार्टी का अगर रूलर सॉरी मेंबर अगर कुछ भी क्वेश्चन करता है this to this minister, then this minister should be having a convincing reply to that member of parliament. Understood? So we can say it's a joint decision of all the MPs for any rule to become a law, for any policy to be implemented. Understood this much? Now, how is the Rajya Sabha formed? The elected members of the legislative assembly of each state elect the members of the Rajya Sabha. So elected members of the legislative assembly of each state, jo legislative assembly ke members hain unme se hi Rajya Sabha ke members ko elect kiya jata hai. That means hum directly Rajya Sabha ke members ke liye vote nahi karte. Kaun karta hai? Jo already humne elect kiya hai wo log aapas mein milke राज्यसभा के लिए मेंबर्स इलेक्ट करते हैं. यू अंडरस्टैंड? दैट मींस हेड प्रिफेक्ट कौन चूज करता है? तुम लोग डायरेक्टली नहीं चूज करोगे, हेड प्रिफेक्ट उनको चूज किया जाएगा जो ऑलरेडी प्रिफेक्ट्स हैं. वो लोग सब आपस में इलेक्शन करेंगे, आपस में चूज करेंगे कि हमको किसको मेंबर बनाना है. अंडरस्टूड? इन दिस वे राज्यसभा इज फॉर्म्ड. देयर आर 250 मेंबर्स इन द राज्यसभा, आउट ऑफ देम 238 आर इलेक्टेड. The remaining 12 members are nominated by the President of India directly. 250 में से 238 को सिर्फ elect किया जाता है, 12 members को directly President nominate करते हैं. The Rajya Sabha is the permanent house. It does not get dissolved completely. पूरा का पूरा Rajya Sabha के elections एक साथ नहीं conduct होते. It never gets dissolved completely. 1/3 of the members of the Rajya Sabha retire every 2 years after completing their 6 years term, and the new members are inducted. So we can say that Rajya Sabha pura ka pura change nahi hota hai. 1/3 of the members change hote hain every 2 years. Aur wo bhi kaun se kinko choose kiya jata hai change karne ke liye? Jinhone apna 6 years ka term complete kiya hai. When are the elections held in the Lok Sabha? We saw every 5 years, but in Rajya Sabha they are elected biannually. That means 1/3 of the members they have to retire. जिनका 6 साल term complete हो गया, उनको वो लोग retire कर देते हैं. Understood? And new members को वो लोग introduce करते हैं. The Rajya Sabha represents the country of our, the states of our country. The Rajya Sabha also can propose a bill. Propose a bill. That means if they wish, if the members of the Rajya Sabha they wish that कोई न्यू बिल इंट्रोड्यूस होना चाहिए, देन दे आल्सो हैव गॉट दिस राइट दैट दे कैन प्रपोज अ बिल. प्रपोजल दे सकते हैं, अपना सजेशन दे सकते हैं, एडवाइस दे सकते हैं. इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट टू हैव द कंसेंट ऑफ द राज्यसभा बिफोर पासिंग द बिल. लोकसभा ने भी अगर कोई बिल प्रपोज किया है, एडवाइस किया है, तब भी राज्यसभा के मेंबर्स का कंसेंट की मंजूरी उसमें जरूरी है. बिना राज्यसभा के मेंबर्स की मंजूरी के वो कोई भी न्यू लॉ बना नहीं सकते. दिस हाउस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट रिव्यूज द बिल पास बाय द लोकसभा. लोकसभा ने जो भी बिल बनाया है, जो भी लॉ बनाने के लिए बोल रहे हैं, राज्यसभा मेंबर्स विल गो थ्रू दैट बिल. थस द रोल ऑफ राज्यसभा इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द पर्सन हु प्रिसाइड्स ओवर द सेशंस ऑफ द राज्यसभा इज नोन एज द चेयरमैन. द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट्स एज द चेयरमैन ऑफ द राज्यसभा. तो राज्यसभा का चेयरमैन हेड होता है राज्यसभा का, एंड हु इज द चेयरमैन? ही इज द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया. देयर इज नो डिफरेंट डेजिग्नेशन फॉर द हेड ऑफ द राज्यसभा, बट ही इज द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया. when the parliament is in session at the beginning of the day, the time for the question hour is decided upon. That means at till what time the question session will go on is decided when the parliament session begins. During the question hour, the members of the parliament ask questions to gather information on the working of the government. See, if the education minister, as I told you, has framed a certain rule that he wishes to introduce new policy in the education, but before introducing that policy, before passing that rule or law in whole of the country, he needs to get it approved by all the members of the parliament, may it be the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, dono members, dono lower house and upper house ke members ka consent zaruri hai. Only then the bill becomes the law. So during the question hour, the members of the parliament, unka jo bhi new bill hai, they will introduce that bill, and the other members of the parliament, they will ask the question to gather information which is on which the government is currently working. This is how the parliament controls the executive. Understood what is the role of the executive, what is the function of the executive? To implement the laws. To implement karne ke pehle, they have to recite, go through these Lok Sabha members and Rajya Sabha members ka consent lena, manzoori lena zaruri hai. Through the medium of questioning, members draw the attention of the government towards its loopholes. Loopholes means shortcomings. Agar wo bill mein, agar jo law banane ki wo log soch rahe hain, अगर उसमें कुछ भी गड़बड़ है, उनको लगता है कि कोई भी चीज सही नहीं है, लूप होल्स हैं, तो अदर मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट वो उसकी तरफ गवर्नमेंट का ध्यान लाएंगे कि देखो ये गलती है, ये हमको सुधारनी पड़ेगी. इन दिस वे द गवर्नमेंट कम्स टू नो अबाउट द व्यूज एंड ओपिनियंस ऑफ द पीपल थ्रू देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द मेंबर्स टू क्वेश्चन द गवर्नमेंट. वहां पे जितने भी मेंबर्स मौजूद होते हैं, ये उनकी ड्यूटी होती है टू गो थ्रू दोज लॉज प्रॉपरली. ओके, व्हाई? बिकॉज एक बार अगर वो बिल इम्प्लीमेंट हो जाता है, वो लॉ बन जाता है, देन इट इज गोइंग टू अफेक्ट होल ऑफ द नेशन. सो इट हैज टू बी गॉन थ्रू प्रॉपरली. इट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द मेंबर्स टू क्वेश्चन द गवर्नमेंट. The opposition party plays a major role in the effective administration of a democracy. So, as I told you, there are opposition party members also. Jo ruling party nahi hai, they are called opposition party. You remember, 28 districts mein se 20 were from jo elect hue wo ruling party banenge. Baki ke jo log hain, MP to hain wo, lekin wo log opposition party hai. So, opposition party, as you all know in your class also, you're always ready to fight against the people, the monitors, etc. Okay, this generally happens in your class as well. So what happens at that time? The opposition party that will derive the attention of the government towards the loopholes, and it plays a very major or important effective role in the administration. It highlights the loopholes in the policies and the programs of the government. The person who presides over the sessions in the Lok Sabha is known as the speaker. Here we can see a lady is sitting at a table, and the other side in the picture, in the other side we can see there are different members, different people sitting. They are MPs or member of parliament, and the lady who is sitting on this chair, chair and desk, she is supposed to be the presiding over the sessions of the Lok Sabha, and she is supposed to be the speaker. President is the most important and integral part of the parliament. A bill that is passed by both the houses can become a law only after his signature. So president is the most important and integral part of the parliament. A bill that is passed by both the houses, jo bhi new bill pass karna hai, new law pass karna hai, which is before becoming a law, it is just a bill, just a proposal. So a bill that is passed by both the houses, dono houses, sare MP in the parliament as well as the members of the Rajya Sabha, jab sab log apna consent de dete hain, apni manzoori de dete hain, to ye bill jata hai president ke paas sign hone ke liye. After he signs, the bill becomes a law. So a bill that is passed by both the houses can become a law only after his signature. He has the power to decide about the meetings of the parliament and announces the completion of the sessions too. So the president has the power to decide upon the meetings of the parliament, whether the meeting has to be conducted or not, whether that bill or proposal is important or not, and also whether the decisions taken by the MPs are correct or not, whether the discussion is enough, and if he wishes that enough discussion is being done on that particular bill and now it should be signed and become, it should be made a law, then also he has got that right to complete the session. Understood the whole chapter? Now these are the worksheets. You have to write them in your fair book. Okay, this is the first worksheet, which is also there in your textbook. Okay, all the questions are from your textbook. Always remember that you have to go through the textbook completely. Okay, and you will be able to answer all the questions. This is the second worksheet. These answers also are to be written in your fair book. Okay, hope you understood this chapter. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, everyone.